क्याप्सन दूर शिक्षा संचार सूचना र मनोरंजन को मात्र नभई शिक्षा को माध्यम पनि हो। घरमै संभव छ विद्यालय को पढ़ाई, टेलिभिजनमै आउनुहुन्छ शिक्षकहरु।
Hello everyone, it's me P.P. Dahal. From today onwards, I am going to take your mathematics class. Dear students, I would like to request you to make availability of the study materials, for example, book, copy, pen, eraser, cutter, pencil, geometrical instruments, as well as the calculator, so that there won't be any kind of disturbances while being inside the class. And I have another request as well, dear students. I would like to request you to stay in the peaceful environment so that there won't be any kind of obstacles while being in the classes. So without wasting time, dear students, I would like to go directly towards the courses. And as per the syllabus, dear students, the very first chapter belongs to SET. So as per the first chapter, the SET has two branches. One is elements of SET. Another one is, I'm going to write here, cardinality of SET. Dear students, the set which you have learned in the junior classes, I mean in class 6, class 7 and class 5 as well, that set of data or information is known as elements of set. And then after, the course or the syllabus which includes in the higher level, that means in class 8, class 9 and 10, as well as in the senior classes, for example, in the business math also, and then after other mathematics book also, the set which you learn, that is cardinality of set. Today, being in class 8, you need to understand both, okay, elements of set as well as cardinality of set. But first of all, I want to revise the course of class 7 so that it will be easier to you in the upcoming days to understand the cardinality of set. So dear students, before starting to define or to go throughout the elements of set, I want to define the set, okay? Because although in the examination, you won't be asked to define set, but in the mass or crowd, if somebody asks you, what do you mean by set? Or what do you learn in set? So at the time, you may need the definition. So in my experience, what I have learned about the set, as per that, I am going to define the set. Dear students, set is a systematic representation of ideas, facts, figures, and then after informations which are in quantitative in nature, and then after which are well defined. The information must be well defined in order to be a set. So that's the definition of set. Now I want to focus on elements of set. Dear students, elements of set, in order to understand, the data or information, if are found in detailed form, for example, I'm going to take an example. A set A has the elements from 1 to 9, the natural number 1 to 9. At the time, if you want to write this information through elements of set, there are so many ways. So as per these elements of set, the first way of describing elements of set will be diagrammatic method. Diagrammatic method. That means a set can be defined or can be analyzed by using so many types of diagram. The first one is, of course, you are using the Venn diagram. That's why through the diagrammatic method, the set can be defined. And another one is, dear students, there are so many diagrams that we use in the mathematics, not only the Venn diagram. Another one is bar diagram, pie chart, histogram, and so on. So in case of set, we just use Venn diagram. So diagrammatic method of representing a set refers to preparing a Venn diagram and keeping all the information in that Venn diagram. Okay, another one is there, dear student. The another one is descriptive method. Okay, D-I-S-C-R-I-P, descriptive method. Okay, in this method, dear students, the same information can be written by using words, or you can say, let's say, in language. If you write this information through language, then that is known as descriptive method. For example, if I write this information, A equals to, a set is, A is given as the numbers from 1 to 9. If you have to write this information by using descriptive method at the time, what do you do? A equals to, curly bracket, always while starting the set information, we need to start from the curly bracket. So I'm using curly bracket. And then after, if it is, it has to be in descriptive method. So I'm going to write, what are they? These are the natural number from 1 to 9. That's why A equals to curly bracket natural number less than 10. These numbers belongs to natural number less than 10. So in this way, if you write, that is known as descriptive method. And first one, diagrammatic method. If you represent this information in diagrammatic method, I'm going to write in here, through diagrammatic method, we prepare a Venn diagram, we prepare a rectangle, and then after we keep universal set just attached with the rectangle, and then after we just keep the subset A and the elements of set A, what are they? 1 to 9 should be included inside the circle. 1 comma. After each element, we need to keep comma so that there won't be the two-digit number, or there, in order to make a kind of separation in between the elements. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, comma, 8, and 9. So these are the numbers. In this way, if you write the information, then that is known as this diagrammatic method of representing a set. Now, another one is there, dear student. Another method is set. Builder method, if it's a, you know, a kind of systematic representation of set information by using a source that sign and using a variable. So I'm going to write this one, A set, for example, equals to curly bracket, always we keep the curly bracket, and then after, let's use any variable. For example, you can use X, Y, Z, or any alphabet. Okay, I'm going to use X, so that X belongs to, dear friends, do you know or not, this sign is known as belongs to, okay, B-E-L-O-N-G-S. If rather than writing, we can use in mathematics this symbol. X, so that X belongs to, what are they? So we need to analyze by using logic. That means the language or the words. So do just write natural number less than 10 and close the curly bracket. So this is the way of writing the set builder method of set. Another one is there, dear students, the last one, okay? The last one is listing method, okay? Information can be kept in listing method. Listing or this one method is also in some books we can find as tabular method, okay? Tabular method. And as for this, it's a simple method of representing the elements of a set. Very simple, and mostly while giving the example by teachers as well as by you yourself, whenever had to be written an example at the time, we use this method. This is a common to all the people. That's why listing our tabular method represents A equals to, starting from curly bracket, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. You can give blah, 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 blah sign, and then after the last element is 9, that's why 9. So in this way, if we write, that is known as the way of representing the set information by listing or tabular method. So once again, I want to focus on this one. Elements of set can be defined or can be used by these four methods. The first one is diagrammatic method. By using such type of diagram, if the set of information is represented, that is known as diagrammatic method of representing the elements of set. Similarly, another method is there. That method is descriptive method. And as for this method, description, that means we need to write short notes regarding that information. As the information is to write 1 to 9 natural number, so A equals to curly bracket natural number less than. These are the numbers which are less than 10. And dear friends, natural number always, the first natural number is 1, and then after it goes on towards the positive direction, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. And then after, dear students, set builder method. I have already told, we use a variable and then after we keep such that sign in order to represent the information given to us. So, A equals to curly bracket X such that X belongs to natural number less than 10, and enclose the bracket. Now, another one, listing method or tabular method. As per this method, simply we keep the elements or the members of a set inside the curly bracket. So we need to write the name of the set at the very beginning. So A equals to curly bracket, and then after we give after each element a comma. Then after completing to write all those elements, at last we need to keep again, we need to close the information by another curly bracket. So these are the ways of describing the elements of set. And dear students, one thing you need to remember, the thing is, these methods are not complementary to each other, okay? They are not complementary to each other, but they are substitutionary to each other. Or we can say they are alternative methods of describing the set. That means diagrammatic methods, whatever we represent, although the methods is different, the same information can be converted one to another method. So these are the ways of using the set information. So I want to go to another topic, and I would like to request you to copy this one. You may get the videos through YouTube as well, through Janata Television YouTube channel, and you can copy from there this all information. And let's go to another topic of this elements of set. I'm not using cardinality of set. Later on, we'll focus on cardinality of set. Dear students, now we need to go towards the types of elements of set, okay? What are the types of this one? I'm going to erase this topic also. Later on, we'll use, that's why, why should we keep here? So that you won't be confused. Now, types of set. What are the types of set? You have learned, dear students, in class 7, while being in class 8, class 6 also. So there are no more types of set.
The first one is null set, dear student, null set. And this null set is also known as empty set. So, E-M-P-T-Y, empty set. Null set is also defined as or written as empty set. They are synonyms to each other. Now, dear student, what do you mean by null set or empty set? A set having no elements. There won't be any kind of elements. So, if you have to write to this one, for example, if a set has no elements, then what? How will you write to that one? A equals to, just only we enclose the curly bracket of blank space, empty space. Dear students, some of the students becomes confused. What I have got the experience while teaching is, they write to the null set as this one. No element space. This is wrong, dear students. You cannot write this one. It is a unit set or singleton set. It has one member. Zero is also should be treated by us as a one member of that set. So, it cannot write to this one. And you can write symbolically the null set as the enclosed blank space by the curly bracket. And then after, we can use another sign as well, dear friend. This one sign. And this sign is known as phi, okay? Phi. That means P as I, phi, okay? Phi. While pronouncing to this one, we need to say phi. But while writing symbolically, we write in this way. So null set or empty set represents no elements inside the set. Such type of set is known as null set. Now another one is singleton set. Okay? Singleton. Singleton or this singleton set is also known as unit set, dear friends. In some of the book we find written unit set. Singleton, single, singleton, there is single, so it means a set having only one element, dear friend. Unit also represents one, that's why singleton or unit means a set having just only one element. So, a set, for example, if we need to take an example, then singleton or unit set example will be like this, dear friends. This is singleton set having only one element. You can use other also example, for example, curly bracket and E in this way. So, another one, let's take the another type of set. Another one is finite set. Finite set. Finite set refers to that set where there are fixed numbers or fixed elements or members. That means the last number or the last digit or the last alphabet, if is fixed, that type of set is known as finite set. For example, if I take an example, then A, B, C, D, and the last one is to be fixed. So this type of set is known as finite set. That means a set having certain fixed elements inside the curly bracket, that is known as finite set. Now another one type is there, dear students, that is just opposite to this finite set. What will be? Infinite set. So infinite set. Of course, it should be exactly opposite to this finite set. That means if the definition of this one is the last elements is to be fixed, but in here the last element won't be fixed, dear students. The last element won't be fixed and it goes towards the infinity, towards the infinite direction. That means if I have to write, I'm going to write the natural number 1, 2, 3, and so on, okay, blah, 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 blah. And the last number we should not fix. That type of set is known as infinite set. And sometimes to this one to represent, we use the finite sign. This sign also can be used. So these are the types of set, and other types of sets are also there. As for the if there is a single set, then if we want to use the single only one set, and then after if we want to take out the details of the single set at the time, we use this one. But if the sets are more than two at the time, we can use other set also as the type. Another one, dear students, the fifth number, if you need to include, then you can say as equal set as well. Another equal set, another one is equivalent set as well. So in this way, you can use other sets also. You can understand other sets also, but as they are not necessary to define in here, so I'm not going to define. But if necessary, later on, I will define it. Now I want to go towards that another chapter, dear students, and the relation. Now relations of set. Relations of set. What type of relation will be there in between the two sets? There may be no connection in between them because of not having any common elements in between the two sets or more than two sets. Or there may be a common in between the two sets, having the common elements in between the two sets. So as for that, I am going to write the relation. The first relation is disjoint of set. Dear student, disjoint of set refers to that set where those two sets or more than two sets where the elements in between the two sets are not common. There is no similarity in between the two sets. If so, then that type of set is known as disjoint set. For example, if I take the example of disjoint set, 1 A equals to 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. For example, there are four elements in set A which are 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, another set I am going to take, B set contains the elements as A, B, C, D. Dear students, did you find any similarities in between these two sets? Is there common characteristics in between these two sets? No. That's why, dear students, if there is no common member in between the two sets at the time, the relation in between the two sets is defined as disjoint set. And if you need to represent these two sets in Venn diagram, then what like Venn diagram should be prepared? Look at here. In case of disjoint set, for example, this is a universal set representing universal U sign at the corner of the rectangle. And I'm going to make the circles for the representation of those both sets A and B. So let's write to the circle as A and to the circle as B. Now, look at here. If you write in this way the information, dear students, no elements can be adjusted in the common area. That's why we need to be very sensitive. In case of this joint set, we never prepare the intersected place. That means there must not be any kind of connection. So while preparing, we need to be very careful in case of this joint set. There must not be any kind of connection or joining. So set A, set B. Okay. Now let's keep the elements of set A and let's keep the elements of set B inside the Venn diagram. What happens? In set A, 1, 2, 3, 4. There are four elements. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And as the elements of set B won't match with set A, so it is separately kept inside the rectangle. So A, comma B, comma C, comma D. So in this way, if you represent a set having no common elements in between them, that type of set is known as disjoint of set. Now another one is there, dear student, in overlapping set. Another one is overlapping set. What do you mean by overlapping set? For example, A contains the elements as A, B, C, D up to U. Okay. For example, one set, set A contains the elements from A to U, and B set contains the elements as A, B, C, G, K, that much. Okay. Let's take the example. If you see the elements containing in set A and set B, there is somehow the relation, isn't it? Look at here. There is common nature. A is here and here is also A, and there is B and there is also B. So same as C, D, and so on. So in this way, if you want to make the Venn diagram in between the two sets at the time, there must be certain common area in between the two sets. That means if I represent this information in Venn diagram, then what like Venn diagram will be drawn? Yes, there are common members, so we should make overlapping diagrams. The circles should be, the two circles should be overlapping. If it is the case of three circles, then also at the time we need to prepare another circle in here, and then after there must be made a common area of the whole three circles. Now let's write to this one as A and this one as B. Now first of all, while keeping the information of the given question inside the Venn diagram at the time, dear students, first of all we need to use a technique. The technique is, first of all, see the common elements in between the two sets so that you can write at the very beginning the common element in between the overlapping space. So if the common is ABC, A, B, C, and then after there is which one? MCD, EFG, HIJKL, then G is also common, and then after K is also common, and all the elements, let's you know, keep here another element W, so that you know there won't be empty space in the side of B difference A. So I'm going to keep now the common elements as we have already kept. So let's see the other elements. This W, this side W, because the only one element that contain in B set is W. Now what are we meant to keep in here? A, B, C, G, K, then after other elements A, B, C, D, D is here, and after E, F, G already here. That's why we cannot write, we cannot repeat the elements inside while writing inside the Venn diagram. F, and after H, K already is present here. L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, and up to U. We need to keep here. Yes, there is small space that, so that because of that reason I could not able to write all those elements. So, but up to U in, we need to write inside this A only. So this is the overlapping set. Another one you need to understand is difference of set, dear students. Difference of set. Okay. This means only A, the information containing in only A, and the information containing in only B. That means difference of set refers to A difference B and another B difference A. What are the elements containing in A difference B, and what are the elements containing in B difference A? So A difference B means the elements containing in the area of A only, and the elements containing in B only, W. As per this question, okay, as per this Venn diagram, if we see A difference B means the elements of this area, okay, except this one, and this one. And if we need to take out the elements of B difference A at the time, this area's information, whatever the elements contained in there, we need to copy that. So this is the difference of set. And especially, dear students, I would like to request you, if you have books at home, and if you have the elder brother and sisters or any experts who can guide you mathematics, take the help of them in order to understand these two, because these two play a vital role in the upcoming periods. So, dear friends, today this much, on the next day we'll be providing the next procedures, the next upcoming subtopic of this topic. So I would like to request you, in the upcoming days, stay in the peaceful environment so that there won't be any kind of obstacles or the disturbances, and then after make availability of the study materials. For example, you may need the book, you may need the copy, pencil, eraser, cutter, and then after other geometrical instruments as well as the calculator. So by making ready these all things, if you stay in the class, of course it will be very easier to understand and your class becomes effective, and the way of obtaining the knowledge from us will be efficient and effective. So thank you very much. That's all. Stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you so much.
अहिले विश्वभरि कोभिड-19 ले